Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. So today we are going to begin with our next topic, the Kite Festival 3.2. So kindly remove your textbook, page number 62. Now children, from your childhood you have seen that the Kite Festival usually everyone has in your childhood has been flying the kite. Now in India, the kite flying festival is celebrated at Basant or on Makar Sankranti, and especially in Gujarat, Makar Sankranti is a kite flying day. It is celebrated on January 13 or 14, and it is a holiday where the people meet outdoors to cut out each other's kites. It marks the end of the winter. Kite flying goes on throughout the day. There is competition among the people and there is a lot of enthusiasm around. Music and traditional delicacies are prepared for the occasion, and the festival attracts both national and the international flyers. After sundown, there are illuminated box kites too, especially you have seen during Diwali time. So now let us begin with the extract. That is our topic. Yes, the kite festival. Years ago, the harassed mother would often say to her restless child. The harassed mother means the troubled mother often say to her restless son who needed to be kept busy during his holidays, "Why don't you go and fly a kite?" And the little boy would happily pick up his kite and run out into the field. That, of course, was in the past when the only kites available were made of kite paper and thin wooden frames. Kite flying has come a long way. Certain changes have been made, certain developments have been made in the form of progress, something new, innovations have been made. Since then, with the invention of the motorized and even fiberglass kites to compete with the old-fashioned kites, today kite flyers can be found in the different parts of the world carrying different kinds of kites waiting for the right wind. Now here, in this extract, they are trying to tell that what changes are there. And then the kites are made of the different kinds, fiberglass kites, and then the motorized kites, and to name a few, even there are the box kites, and they are designed more than 100 years ago, and maybe they have probably inspired the others to create the power driven aeroplanes. Kite flying has a long history. There are many Greek, Indian and the other mythological stories which tells us about the human beings wanting to or trying to fly. So even our history has got the evidences that and it is a story also that the human being could fly with the help of what. Over a period of time, this desire of humans and their imagination probably led to the invention of kites. And it is likely that the box kites and designed more than 100 years ago later inspired others to create the power-driven aeroplane. So in this paragraph, they had explained us that the desire, the curiosity, the intention of the humans and their imagination, that was the basic probably the thinking, the imagination, the creativity which has led to the invention of kites. And even they have said that the box kites which have been designed nowadays, they are more than 100 years ago, and then later it only inspired the others to create the power driven aeroplane. In India, however, the tradition of the kite flying has not changed, be it during the coming of spring, which is celebrated as Basant. Now, Basant comes in the month of the Now, see, according to the Hindu calendar, we have various months. Basant is there, we have got many more such months. Okay, and during festival of the Makar Sankranti, people of all ages go out into the open to try their luck with their kites. In towns and the cities where the open spaces are difficult to find, terraces and the rooftops are often used for the traditional sport. See, when in the villages where the open spaces available, where the kite flying can be done, but in the towns and the cities where the open space is hardly available, so the rooftop or the terraces, they have been used for such kind of the activity to fly the kite. In Gujarat, Makar Sankranti is a kite flying day traditionally celebrated on January 13 or 14. That means every year we celebrate Makar Sankranti on the same day, that is the 13 or 14 of the January month. It is a holiday when the people meet outdoors to cut the each other's kite. So we can see here that the varieties of the kite also seen in the sky on that particular day. And Makar Sankranti or the Basant, if you call it, see, in India we have various months. We have Shravan and all the other months. So Makar Sankranti or the Basant, now these are the festivals that is in our culture, that is in our tradition, and we have the tradition of kite flying. Especially in Gujarat, Makar Sankranti is a kite flying day. And this day also coincides with the festival of Uttarayan, when the sun is said to begin its journey to the northern hemisphere. The people of the Gujarat celebrate Uttarayan with a lot of enthusiasm, and all business comes to a grinding halt for a couple of days. It is also a celebration to mark the end of winter. The kite flying begins at the dawn and continues without a pause throughout the day. That means it begins early in the morning, and then till dusk it is being carried out. Dawn and the dusk, these are the antonyms, the opposite. Now, in this paragraph, it is mentioned that this day coincides with the festival of Uttarayan. Now, what do you mean by Uttarayan? That is this. It is said that when the sun begins its journey to the northern hemisphere. Now, this we can understand properly by the diagram. See, if you look at this diagram. Now, this is sun. This is Earth revolving. Now, Dakshinayan and Uttarayan. If you look how the movement of the Earth it is. Now, from 21st June till the 14th January, it is Dakshinayan, and when it is moving towards the northern side, when the Earth is moving towards the now here it is said that the sun is said to begin its journey to the northern hemisphere. The sun doesn't move. It is the Earth which is revolving around the sun, so it faces towards the sun. The northern hemisphere faces towards the sun. So it is called as the Uttarayan. This is north, this is south, this is west, this is east, and this position is called as the Uttarayan position, and this position is called as the Dakshinayan. People of all ages gather on terraces or rooftop. Friends, neighbors, even total strangers compete with one another, and the cries of the trump rend the air when someone cuts the line of a rival. Now, here rivals are the competitors, you say. They are not enemies, but they are the competitors. And rend is the tear. When they tear, the end, that means what? How the kite is flying. See, when the kite is flying in the air, it is as if it is whirling, that means it is steering the air and then moving ahead. A wonderful variety of the kites is seen, and the fussy buyer, very choosy buyer, can choose what he wants. The more serious players prepare special lines for their kites. There is music in the air, and the traditional delicacies are specially prepared for the day. Delicacies, fine and special food items that have been prepared on that day specially. Now, held on the same day, the bigger event, however, is the International Kite Festival at Ahmedabad, organized by the Gujarat State Tourism Corporation. It is held either at the Sardar Patel Stadium or at the Police Stadium. Now, here they had mentioned that where it is held. The International Kite Festival in our country is held at Ahmedabad. And it is organized by whom? It is organized by Gujarat State Tourism Corporation. And where it is held? It is held at the Sardar Patel Stadium or Police Stadium. This popular festival attracts international kite flyers who demonstrate their skills in flying exotic kites. Exotic kites, that means what? Those belong to faraway lands. And the local champions as well, and little Indian paper kites compared with those from Japan, USA, UK and other countries, excited spectators, that is the audience of spectators, watch in awe, watch in surprise, in amazement you can call it, or in wonder, as marvelous shapes such as eagles and snakes soar into the sky. So they are comparing that the kites, how they are being, as being, they have the shapes of the eagles and the snakes that soar high into the sky. One of the highlights of the festival is the Patang or the Kite Bazaar in the heart of the Ahmedabad, which is 24 hours open. Now just imagine any market which is open 24 hours. So feel how there is a craze of the people is there, which is open 24 hours a day for a whole week, and a visit to this bazaar in the middle of the night is enough to prove that the entire city is obsessed with kites. Now obsessed means what? Now they are totally occupied with, whenever a person is being totally occupied only with one aspect, or he wants any one particular thing is there in his mind, that is known as obsessed. So here that proves the point that the total city is obsessed with the kite. People crowd the streets and buy their stocks, haggling throughout the night. That means they go on bargaining. Skilled craftsmen demonstrate age-old kite making skills and how to prepare the special thread used for kite flying. Mixtures of glue and the ground glass cover the lines, which are dried and rolled into reels known as firkis. Now the firki is a Hindi word, and even the patang is also Hindi word. These lines are so sharp that if they are used carelessly, they can cut a finger, because it is made of mixture of glue and the ground glass. The excitement does not end with nightfall. Now it is a time for illuminated box kites. Till afternoon or till evening, how it was? It was just the kite were flying, but the excitement does not end here. It carries on till the dusk. The excitement does not end with the nightfall. Now it is a time for illuminated box kites. Illuminated means which are lighted up, often strung on one line to be launched into the sky, called as tukals. They add a grand beauty to the dark sky and compete with the brilliance of stars. So here we find that the end of the day, the fun continues with a new type of the illuminated kite. Especially they are made for the night call as a box kites. and which are launched into the sky, and they are also called tukals. So like, as we celebrate every festival in India with full of zeal and enthusiasm, similarly this is also a kind of festival which usually everyone loves to enjoy, especially, and it is celebrated in Gujarat as an international Pride festival in Ahmedabad. So I hope you all have understood the topic very well, the Pride festival. And if you all like my educational video, kindly like it and subscribe it. Thank you, children. God bless you all.